Hello children, today in our science class we are going to learn unit 1, My Body. Students, take your science book, volume 2, term 1, page number 82. Our first lesson is My Body. Students, as you all know, human body is like a machine. It works with the help of its different parts. These different parts of our body perform different functions. So, now we are going to learn about the internal organs. What do you mean by internal organs? The name itself denotes. Internal organ is nothing but the body parts or the organs which we cannot see them because it is present inside our body. So, they are called as internal organs. Students, let us learn more about these parts now.
Internal organs. Students, there are some body parts such as brain, lungs, stomach, heart, kidneys, bones and muscles that are present inside our body. Every organ has its own function. So, let us learn about one by one. Brain. Students, look this picture. What is this? It is human brain. It is a very important organ of our body. It is protected in a safe box. You know, it is called skull. Students, brain. It is protected by skull. This brain is divided into three parts: forebrain, midbrain, hindbrain. Forebrain is the front part of the brain. Mid is nothing but the middle part of the brain. Hindbrain is the back side of the brain. Students, brain controls all our body movements. Every action that we do, like moving our hands, sitting or walking, is because of our brain. Brain helps us to think. Now, I am going to tell an interesting fact. You know that human brain weighs about 1.3 kilograms. By using a balloon. Now I am going to blow this balloon. Student, what will you observe? The balloon becomes bigger. Likewise, if you breathe in oxygen, our lungs also become bigger. It expands. Students, now I am going to explain how it began to its original position. Look, this balloon, it is bigger because we take in oxygen. Now I am going to let the air out. Now it becomes its original position. Likewise, when we breathe in, we breathe oxygen. Our lungs become bigger. When we breathe out, we out the carbon dioxide. Our lungs become in its original position. So, hope you understand. Let's move on to another organ. The next organ is stomach. It is a J-shaped organ. Stomach helps us to digest our food. How it digests? Whatever we are eating, it breaks into a simple particles and gives us energy. It contains a special juice to break down the food we take in, and it gives energy. Students, the next organ we are going to see is heart. Human heart. Human heart is hollow and a muscular organ made up of muscles. The organ heart pumps blood to various parts of our body. The size of the heart is our size of a fist. Almost, it pumps blood to almost all parts of our body. It lies in between the lungs. Students, now I am going to tell an amazing fact about our heart. Our heart beats about 72. Let's see a small video related to the activity. How to make stethoscope. Now, we are moving on to the next organ, kidneys. We have two kidneys. Students,
our heart is the pumping organ. It pumps blood to all parts of the body. It lies in between the lungs, almost in the center of the chest. It's made up of muscles. The heart beats about 72 times in a minute. Let us make a stethoscope. Things we need: duct tape, medium-sized balloon, small funnel, and scissor, flexible tube, and
exactly half of a single kidney is capable of doing the job. that is performed by the two kidneys together.
Students, the next organ we are going to see is bones and muscles. Here, now I am showing the bones picture, a skeleton. Our body is made up of bones, which give shape to our body. They are the frame for our body and allow us to jump, run and walk. Students, now look at your hand, touch the wrist. You can feel some hard part, that is called bone. Vitamin D and calcium is good for our bone development. Now we are going to see about muscles. Muscles are the soft part of the body that covers our bone. They help us to move different parts of our body by tightening and loosening like a rubber band. The portion that feels soft in our body is our muscles. In order to maintain a strong muscle, we need to exercise and stay active. Students, hope you have enjoyed the lesson. In our next class, I will teach the rest of the portion. Thank you.